All right, we are back with our third video on the shoulder. So the last two that we did the biceps and we did a arterial compression at the front of the shoulder. So next, I want to cover the most common, the second most common impingement that I see in the office, and that's of the supraspinatus. So let me give you a quick rundown of what the supraspinatus is. So this is the back of your body right here, and this is your trapezius muscle and your deltoid. And if we remove those two, you can see your shoulder blade right here. And then there's a bony ridge on your shoulder blade called your spine. And on top of that is your supraspinatus. Now, if I turn the page, here is a top view of it. So you can see your collarbone and your spine, and then that supraspinatus comes underneath those. Now, if it gets thick and swollen and you go into an overhead position, what's going to happen is that tendon's going to hit this bridge, and then it's typically going to give you referral pain down the arm. And I'll show you where that is. So here's where the supraspinatus sits on me. It's gonna come right here, and then it attaches right here. And its primary function is to lift my arm up like this. So when it's thick and swollen and it hits that bridge, it's gonna give a referral coming down the arm that's kind of vague right here. And what most people complain of is they can't do this. So that is the chicken dance. They can't do the chicken dance. So I always say that as my dad joke. But the way that we treat this is if we come with our ball and we kind of press right into that area, and then we're going to reach behind our back. So we kind of, any kind of door frame or solid object like this, and then just take your arm and go behind the back over and over again with it. And now afterwards, we want to try to stretch it. And the way that we're going to stretch it is if we grab a hold of something solid and we come out and we tilt like this, and we tilt our head away. What we're doing is we're stretching that muscle right through there. So after we kind of smash into it and get it to loosen up a little bit, then we want to stretch it out for about a minute or two. And just like all the other impingements, if it interferes with an activity 2 to 3 times, and you're working through it with these activities, these demonstrations that we're showing, and you're still not getting any relief, then it means you've got an injury and you need to seek some professional care for it. So give us a call if you need us. We'd be happy to help. Have a good day. Thanks.